Endrick, a 17-year-old, soon-to-be 18-year-old Brazilian striker, is set to be presented later in this month of July, in which on his birthday, apparently he's going to do his presentation for Real Madrid. Now, I'm not gonna lie, in recent games, in his Copa America games, in particular, the Uruguay match, Endrick just did not look at his best. And if I'm being honest with you, even as a Madrid fan, the performance was laughable. Now, he's 17, I know it's crazy to now say that, oh, that was a disappointing performance, because he's playing against grown men. But at the moment, I'm thinking too much about Lamine Yamal, Hardegul, how they are playing at their ages. And I'm thinking there's no excuse for Endrick. But of course, Copa America is different. These players play crazy, they play dangerous. I can give Endrick that excuse. And he's getting a lot of hate on the internet. People are saying all kinds of things about him. Matter of fact, in his performance against Uruguay, which was a shameful performance. But let's be honest, everybody has a day off. Everybody has a bad day. Some very experienced players have terrible games, and it's completely cool. And there are a lot of fans who are doubting Endrick now. They're saying he should not join Real Madrid. Instead, he should be loaned out or something. And let me tell you something. He played way better in other matches. For instance, two matches. His match against England, which he scored against England at Wembley. Then he scored against Spain at the Bernabeu. Don't let these performances now make you think that he's a terrible player. Because he's not. I actually think he's an above average youngster. He's going to be the future for our club. He's going to do great things. But don't set your expectations too high for him. And many people ask the question, is he ready for Madrid? Like, is he actually ready for Real Madrid? And my answer is, no, I don't think so. I don't think that any player is fully ready for Real Madrid. But when they get there, Real Madrid takes them, makes them a far better player by using big fitness coaches like Pintas to whip these people into Madrid shape. And then I think they're ready for Real Madrid. If you have to ask me if Endrick is a good player, I think he's a very good player. But I don't think he's the best. I don't think he's the next Pele. I don't think he's on the level of Odegaard or Yamal or Bellingham. And we're going to have to just give him a chance. We have to see what he's made of. At the end of the day, we should not be putting too much pressure on him. Because even though I did not watch the match of Brazil against Uruguay, because those matches happened at 2 a.m. for me, but I watched his highlights, just highlights based on his performance. He looked very nervous in that match. Now, yes, nervousness plays a huge impact in how you play, because I saw how he was on the ball. He looked like he couldn't even hold the ball properly at his feet. And with pre-season coming up, it's coming up in about 10 days. Let me tell you something, he's not going to participate just yet. Only later on in the month he will participate. And that's not because he's unfit. It's just that he's not 18 yet. The deal was that when he turns 18, then he's eligible for Real Madrid to use. But if he does get to play preseason, I'm super excited. Because then we get to see our youngsters cook. We get to see how Odegaard and Endrick play together. We're going to see so much different possibilities. Let's speak about Endrick as a player, because he is a very stocky player. He's big for his age and he can muscle a player off the ball. But against world-class players, I don't think so. He still gets pushed off the ball easily. And I'm wondering, is he going to be the type of player who only gets one touch on the ball or passes only one complete pass? Because if that is what he brings, then I have my doubts. But based on his highlights, you can tell that he is a skillful player. He does play with the team. But also when I watch his highlights, you can see that he's not going up against the best defenders in the world. We can't judge that based on Europe. And one of the most important things is that, similar to previous Brazilians, Vinicius Rodrigo, if you look at their evolution, when they joined up with the squad, they were not the best players in the world. And you have to also take that into account with Endrick. He's not going to immediately play like Vinicius or Prime Neymar. And he's going to be a backup striker for Mbappe. Now, Mbappe is leagues above him. Endrick is not on that level yet, so he's going to have to accept a bench role. If he doesn't, then what is he doing at the club? I think he's going to be nothing but a bench player. Don't think he's going to break into the starting 11. And I think fans have to understand that he's not him. He's not him. He's not going to break into the starting 11. Not even Arda could do that in his first season. And as rumors are going, they're saying his official shirt number will be the number 16. For those of you who have been knowing about Endrick for years, number 16 was his number for Palmeiras before number 9. But don't let it seem like I'm glazing Endrick here, because I'm not. I still think that we should not have sold Arsalu. Endrick is very, very short. You can't offer us what a backup striker like Arsalu could. Arsalu was a beast in the air. Endrick has no presence in the air. But further on, even if he performs badly for us in the beginning of the season, that does not mean I think that he should leave the club. I just think we should give him time. And is he ready for Real Madrid? I think he is. But up here is another video. And if you enjoyed the video, smash like, subscribe, turn on notifications. Peace out.